December and January 2001, 2002. And I helped people get assistance who had lost their jobs as a result of the World Trade Center being destroyed on the first floor of the AT&T building near Ground Zero. I always told the man or lady, they all came in very frightened. They didn't know if they were going to be helped or not. So I would talk to them and I said, I'm Bob. Call me Bob. I see you're John. Now John, let's pretend now that you and I are the best of friends. And right now, from my standpoint, you're the most important person in the world. And I have the privilege of maybe assisting you or helping you somewhere. So this set put him at ease. We were on the best of team terms, and we were able to elicit smiles from the clients, which was always nice to do. After I came back, I started coughing, and I coughed for 9 days, 24 hours a day. I couldn't eat, couldn't sleep, couldn't drink, couldn't even talk. It was constant coughing, and I coughed off 18 pounds. And the family here, and he threatened to come down and take me out of the house, take me to the hospital. But my wife finally took me, and they determined that I had an infection in every major organ of the body. And my vocal cords, because of the coughing, my vocal cords are like this, whereas yours are like this. So I don't talk with my vocal cords, they don't touch. So I have to talk from what's called the voice box down in here. And as a result, I can't speak very loudly. And I think I sound like a lady when I'm on TV. Of course, to think that I was right down there in the middle of all that, luckily later. But when I was came off the platform, I was so overcome that I went down to the church on the front of it and sat down on the little recessed area there. And I leaned back and I looked up. And what did I see but a t-shirt hanging up there with Ithaca on it? That's my hometown, Ithaca, New York. So someone had come from Ithaca and left their t-shirt there as a memento to all the ones who had lost their lives. There were souvenirs and pictures everywhere of the people who wanted to honor their loved ones.